Okay, good afternoon students. See, in the last class we discussed about the concept of subsets, okay, and we counted the number of subsets and the total number of subsets as 2 power n for a given set, and the number of empty subset is only 1 for any given set, and the number of improper subsets is also only 1, whereas number of proper subsets is 2 power n minus 1. So we discussed about these items in the last class, and now just look there. See, there is a set Q is equals to 2 3 5 7 11, okay. There are 5 elements in the set 2 3 5 7 11, and it is very clear that n of Q is equals to 5. So that in a sense number of elements in that particular set is 5. Now we need to answer these questions. Just look at the first question. Total number of subsets. The first one is what? Total number of subsets. Okay. See, if a set has n elements, then the total number of subsets are just, the formula is 2 power n, and here it is 5. So 2 power 5 is equals to 32. So the total number of subsets for the given set Q is 2 power 5, and that is 32. There ends the first one. Next, think about the second one. Singleton subsets. They are asking us to find the number of singleton subsets. Singleton subset means it's a set having only one element, and specifically here it is a subset of the given set Q. So you look there. Singleton 2 is a singleton subset for Q. Singleton 3 is a singleton subset for Q. Like that, singleton 2, singleton 3, singleton 5, singleton 7, and singleton 11. And there are totally 5 singleton subsets for the given set Q. And if you wish to generalize, if there is a set with n elements, then it has n singleton subsets, because every element will give us one singleton subset. And that's why the number of singleton subsets, if you generalize it, is n. As a formula, you just take it as n. And in particular here, that n is 5. So your answer is 5. And the next one is, number of proper subsets. As I mentioned you, number of proper subsets are the subsets if you eliminate the improper. There is only one improper subset for every set. So the number of proper subsets, the formula is 2 power n minus 1. And if you write 2 power 5 minus 1 is equals to 31. These are the number of proper subsets. And the next one is somewhat interesting. Just look there. Number of subsets which contain 2. Okay, you just identify it. See, analyze the situation. Number of subsets which contain 2. For the given set Q having 5 elements, total number of subsets are 32. And if you observe those 32 subsets, in some sets 2 is involved, in some sets 2 is not involved. Okay, that means 2 is included in some subsets, 2 is not included in some of the subsets. And here we need to count the number of subsets where 2 is compulsorily included. Okay, right. So since 2 must be included, we need to include 2 for must in our subset. So for that, what I do is, there are 5 elements. Okay, you just think about it. First of all, from this Q having 2, 3, 5, 7 elements, you just separate 2. I am giving you the discussion, right? Separate 2 from Q. If you separate 2 from Q, then you left with the elements 3, 5, 7, 11. And if you observe the 3, 5, 7, 11, there are 4 elements, and here the number of subsets are 2 power 4, and that is equals to 16. Okay? What are those 16? These 16 are the subsets of this set having 3, 5, 7, 11 elements. And now you just write this 2 in those 16 subsets. There are 16 subsets for this set, and after having those 16 subsets, if you write 2 there, and these are the 16 subsets which contain 2 for the given set. Okay, see, if you wish to discuss, you just look there. See, for this set containing 3, 5, 7, 11, what will be the subsets? What are the subsets? Empty set as well as singleton sets. Singleton 3, singleton 5, singleton 7, singleton 11. And then 2-2 elements, set containing 3, 5, set containing 5, 7, like that I will write. And then 3 elements, set containing 3, 5, 7, so 3 elemented subsets. And then 4 elements, set containing 3, 5, 7, 11 is a subset. And see, I am not right, I won't write all these subsets of 2 elements and 3 elements, okay? If you write all those and then if you count, these total number of subsets are 16. And now what I am going to do is, I will just write that 2 in each and every subset, every set of these 16. If I include 2 here, it becomes set containing 2, 3. And that set containing 2, 3 is a subset of the given set which contains 2, okay? And if you write 2 in this set, it is singleton 2, which is again a subset of Q which contains 2. So there ends, if they ask us to find out the number of subsets which contain 2, first you just separate 2 and then find the subsets for the remaining elements. After that, that is your answer actually. And if you think why this 2^4 is as your answer, it is clear that if you add these 2 for those 16, and these are nothing but the required subsets which contain 2 for the given set. And that's why we need to think in such a way that if they ask us to find the number of subsets which contain 2 or which contain 3 or which contain 5, like that, any one of those, okay? You just separate that particular element and then list all the subsets, and these are the required subsets, okay? So these are the first 4 questions, okay? Right. And then I will erase this discussion and then I will discuss the next one. The number of subsets which contain 7, 11. Okay, just think about it. The number of subsets which contain 7, 11. And now we are discussing this area. See, which not contain 7, 11. Okay, I need to write a subset for the given set of Q, but in that subset 7 and 11 are not included. Okay, I don't want that 7 and 11. Okay, so since I don't want that 7 and 11, first of all, you just throw those 7 and 11. That is the sense, you just separate that 7 and 11. Again, as in the above case, since you don't want 7 and 11, you just separate 7 and 11. Okay? If you separate 7 and 11, then you will have that 3, 5 and 2 also. Okay? And then, see, for this 3, 5 and 2, the number of subsets are 2 cube and that is equals to 8. These 8 are the required subsets which not contain 7, 11 for the given set Q. You need to think, okay, you need to analyze, okay, right? Once again look there, I need the number of subsets which does not contain 7, 11. Since you don't need 7 and 11, just separate them and then throw it out. Then you left with 3 elements, and the number of subsets for this set containing 3 elements are equal to the number of subsets which not contain 7, 11 for the given set, okay? And the next thing is, look there, the number of subsets which contain 3 and not containing 5. Again the same thing, you need to separate 3 and 5. First of all, you need to separate 3 and 5, then the remaining elements are 2, 7, 11. And for this 2, 7, 11, the number of subsets are 8, okay? See, I separated 3 and 5 first. And then I need the subsets which contain 3 but not containing 5. Not containing 5. Already I separated 3 and 5. Since I need to find the subsets which not contains 5, so you just throw that 5. And now you have 3 in your hands. You just write that 3 in each and every subset of this 3 elemented set. That means in these 8 subsets, you just write 3. And now the newly formed subsets are the required subsets. Okay? Just have a look. You need to think, okay? Right. So at the end, if I have a set containing 5 elements, then in such a way I will answer the questions, the number of subsets which contain 2, the number of subsets which not contain 7, 11, and everything. Just have a look. This is 8A. This is there. The total number of subsets are 32 here. Okay. And among those 32 subsets, number of subsets which contain 2 are 16. And in the same way, number of subsets which not containing 2 are again 16. Because out of 32, in 16 subsets there is 2. And automatically in the remaining 16 there is no 2. Is it right? And that's why the way of calculating that 16 is same. If they ask us to find the number of subsets which contain 2, separate 2 and write all the subsets. Or if they ask us number of subsets which not containing 2, then also separate 2 and write all the subsets. The same procedure, the same count, the same number. Okay. But actually if you try to list out all the 16 subsets, then the way is different. If you are trying to list out all the 16 subsets which contains 2, first write the 16 subsets for this set and write 2 in each and every subset. Those are the required subsets for me. And if they ask us the number of subsets which not contain 2, you just take this 2 and throw it out. Now you have just these 4 elements and the number of subsets are 16. Those 16 are directly the required subsets. Okay, you need to think, okay, if you still have any confusion, take some elements and then list out all the subsets and then observe it, right? Just have a look. Right. Then 8b, you just look there. Now for the next discussion, I will give you one formula which usually we derived it from the permutations and combinations, but it is not there, but it is not covered at present. But we have to use that particular formula. And what is that formula? Just look there. Selection of R objects out of N. Selection of R objects out of N. And in particularly, number of ways of selecting R object out of N is usually given by the notation NCR. What is that C? What is that R? Everything, it comes under permutations and combinations. It is not yet covered, but we need that formula now. So that's why just I mentioned you that formula. See, NCR means what? Selecting R objects out of N. That's it. Is it clear? Yeah. And I will give you one example. Number of ways of selecting. Number of ways of selecting. Some 3 students out of 10. Number of ways of selecting 3 students out of 10 is just nothing but 10C3. So NCR means selecting R out of N. 10C3 means selecting 3 out of 10. That's it. And how to calculate this 10C3? That's what you need to think. The way of calculating this 10C3 is just nothing but, this is equals to, just observe it. Since here it is 3, you just start with 10 and write 3 numbers. 10 into 9 into 8. Okay, start with 10 and write 3 numbers. Okay, divided by, in the divided by, since it is 3, 3 into 2 into 1. And if you count, this is equals to 3 threes and then 2 fours. 4 threes is 12 and 10, 120. Okay, so for suppose if you think there are 10 students in a class, if the teacher wishes to select 3 persons out of the class, then the teacher has 120 chances. Okay, roll number 1, roll number 2, roll number 3. Roll number 1, roll number 2, roll number 4. Roll number 1, roll number 2, roll number 5. Roll number 1, roll number 2, roll number 6. Like that, if you manage, there are 120 chances for the teacher to select 3 persons from the class of 10 students. Okay, now from this discussion, you need to memorize the rule that NCR is the number of ways of selecting R objects out of N. And the value of that NCR or the 10C3 can be calculated in such a manner. How? You just start with 10, write 3 numbers. You just start with 3 and write 3 numbers in the denominator. Its simplification is 120. Again, we will discuss about this NCR notation in permutations and combinations, okay, in some other time. But here what we need? I need that rule, that's enough. Okay, just have a look and I will give you in C some problems where we use this formula to find the number of subsets. Okay. Right, I am erasing this. C. So, for example, here I have a set containing 5 elements, right? Yeah. The first thing is number of subsets of Q. That Q, as we mentioned in above case, number of subsets of Q having 0 elements. See, the elements are 0. That in the sense, no elements are, if you say, number of subsets of Q having no elements. No elements in the sense empty subset. And we know that the empty subset is 1 only. But as per our discussion, number of subsets of Q having 0 elements is just nothing but there are 5 elements and we are not selecting no element. There are 5 elements and we are not selecting no elements. It can be written like phi c 0. Okay? As we discussed in that case, phi c 0 is how to write. Okay? And that phi c 0 value is actually 1. That particular formula won't work here for phi c 0. You just think about this. See, memorize it like that. Phi c 0 is 1. The number of ways of selecting no elements from the set containing 5 elements. Okay? See, there is a set containing 5 elements. In how many ways I can select no elements? There is one chance having empty hands. That is one chance. Okay? So that is 1. And the next case is number of subsets of Q having 1 element. Number of subsets of Q having 1 element. Okay? See, 1 element in the sense singleton set. Just I mentioned you in A, singleton subsets are how many? Because there are 5 elements, 5. But as for the formula here, we need to take phi c1. This phi c1 is nothing but this is 1, right? So, start with 5, write only one number in the denominator 1 and that is equals to 5. Number of subsets having 1 element is 5. And the same discussion, number of subsets of Q having 2 elements. Number of subsets of Q having 2 elements in the sense, phi c2. Okay. See, how many 2-elemented subsets are there for this Q? By listing to count, it is somewhat difficult. But this formula simplifies your work. Phi c2 is, since it is 2, start with 5, write 2 numbers, start with 2, write 2 numbers. 5 into 4 by 2 into 1 and that value is 10. So, if you wish to list out all the 2-elemented subsets, you must get it as 10. Okay, if you need, just take it. 2, 3, 2, 5, 2, 7, 2, 11. And then 3, 5, 3, 7, 3, 11. And then 5, 7, 5, 11. And then 7, 11. There are 10, there are, okay. And the number of subsets of Q having 3 elements. And the number of subsets of Q having 3 elements are just nothing but phi c3. Now since it is 3, you need to write 3 numbers. 5 into 4 into 3 divided by 3 into 2 into 1. Again if you calculate, that is 10. Okay. 3 elemented subsets are also 10. And the number of 4 elemented subsets. And it is phi c4. Phi c4 means start with 5, write 4 elements. 5 into 4 into 3 into 2 divided by 4 into 3 into 2 into 1. Okay? And now this 4, 3, 2 and this 4, 3, 2 get cancelled. You left with again 5. And the last one, number of subsets with 5 elements. Number of subsets with 5 elements is phi c5. Phi c5 means in the numerator start with 5, write 5 numbers. In the denominator start with 5 and again write 5 numbers. That calculation again gives you 1. So the number of 5 elemented subset is nothing but the subset itself. And we call it as improper subset. And that is 1. Number of 6 elemented subsets. Is there any possibility that? No. Since it has only 5 elements, the maximum number of elements in a subset is 5. Okay. And now, yeah, once again if you look there, there is a set having 5 elements. So, we can construct 0 element subsets, 1 element, 2 element, 3 element, 4 element and 5 element subsets. But there is no chance to construct 6 elemented subsets, right? So, and these are the total subsets. Now, if you count these total subsets, okay, 1, 5, okay, how much it is? 6 and 10, 16 and 10, 26 and 5, 31 and 1, how many? 32. And these 32 are the total number of subsets. Is it clear? See, in the last class, I listed subsets for a set containing 3 elements. There I mentioned you clearly that 0 element subsets, singleton subsets, 2 element subsets, 5 element subsets, like that. Like that, if you list all the subsets and then if you count, 0 element subsets are this phi c0, 1 element subsets are this phi c1, 2 element subsets are this phi c2, like that phi c3, phi c4, phi c5. And if you add all these things, you still get that 32, which indicates the total number of subsets. Is it clear? Just analyze it. Okay. With n, if I discuss, it may create some confusion for you. And that's why I took an example here having 5 elements and I discussed everything with that 5 itself. Okay. Now, you just explore it, you just extend it for the set containing n elements if you need. Okay, just observe it, go for a screenshot. Okay, just an observation from C. Okay, 2 power 5 means total subsets. 5C0 means no elemented subsets. C1 means 1 element subsets, 2 elemented subsets, 3 elemented subsets, 4 elemented subsets, 5 elemented subsets, and all those subsets will give nothing but 2 power 5, and this is an observation from this, from the discussion of C. In the same way, similarly, what I am going to tell you is, if n of q is equals to 6, then what can we do? If the number of elements in the set q is 6, then 2 power 6 is equals to 6 is 0 plus and so on plus 6 is 6 also we will get. Okay, but actually not required at this situation, just observe it and that's enough. Okay, and then next point is 9.